KFWB. KFWB HD, Los Angeles.
It's a New Year's tradition, and it's watched in more than 200 countries. The world's biggest New Year's celebration. And on this New Year's Day, you have a front row seat. The 124th Pasadena Tournament of Roses Parade. You are listening to special KFWB News Talk 980 coverage with your hosts, Cindy Dole and Eric Stromer.
A happy new year, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Here we are today. It's exciting. It's yes. a chilly morning here in Pasadena, and Eric and I are right here as the action is unfolding. And thanks to our partners at Lions Clubs International, we're going to be bringing you 2 full hours of all the excitement you may be watching on TV. Turn the volume down. Listen to us. We have better stories.
Yeah, we've got an amazing seat here right at the top of the Rose Parade bleachers, and we are about to see our first float come through. And it's about 35 degrees, would you say?
It's okay. I mean, you know, we've got some folks from Wisconsin. You know, the Badgers
they
are here.
This is springtime for them.
They're wearing shorts.
Yeah, they sure are.
But the parade is about to begin, and this year, like last, it starts with a little bit of a mini show with flag twirlers and then a man holding a larger than life-size puppet of a guy with a knapsack on his back, because the theme this year is Oh, the Places You'll Go. And
that's
you read
right.
that book. You love
it. That's one of my favorite books. I read it to my kids the last 14 years, and I tell you, it's to me the book of life.
You know, I haven't read it.
You take a look at that book, and it kind of gives you an idea and understanding of a simplistic way to look at how life is. I love it. It's a great theme.
The Dr. Seuss book. And
sure.
So that message is going to be coming throughout the parade, all about adventure and travel and accomplishment, right?
That's right.
And we're going to be seeing 41 floats, 200 bands, 300 horses, and the list goes on and on and flowers.
And speaking of bands, I mean, it takes how many? The competition is so fierce to get a band here in the first place.
It is
hundreds
an honor.
And hundreds of bands audition to get into
they
this
do.
Parade.
In fact, and there's just 22 spots. To be a band in this parade. So every time a band goes by, we salute them and say,
we
yay!
Sure do, yeah. Proud of them.
Yay!
Huge accomplishment.
So this is one of the most watched spectacles in the land and in the world. And by the way, if you are watching the parade along the route and listening to us, thanks for hanging out, because we're going to give you all the great stories. Eric and I spent all the time at the making of the floats.
We sure did. We saw a lot of these that we're about to see under construction from point A to point B. And boy, the flowers have really made them come alive, haven't they?
Well, not only that, you got to sit in the driver's seat.
I did, and boy, there are a couple of driver's seats in here that are basically like plywood and metal framing, and that's about it. But the Honda float, apparently, has a really great car that's a low emissions car, so they're kind of paying attention to the environment as they're driving down this Pasadena Boulevard.
So, I mean, I want to know, what are you going to tell Amy and the kids when you come home after the parade today driving a float?
I'm going to say, guess what I did?
It's a new family vehicle.
Yeah,
hey,
exactly.
All the groceries.
I mean, we'll get to school, but it'll take about 3 hours.
Well, let's listen to, this is the president of the Tournament of Roses, Sally Bixby. Now, coincidentally, Sally Bixby is the first nurse to be the president of the Tournament of Roses, the second woman to hold that position, and she says that, you know what, she has good reason to always be calm after spending 37 years in the operating room as a nurse.
That's amazing, and you know, we did spend some time speaking to some of the nurses on one of the floats that's going to pass through here,
right.
And I'm so proud of these people because, they save your life when you're in the hospital, and they're the ones that are the go-to people when it comes to communication.
They fluff your pillow, they say, Eric, can we give you a blankie?
Oh, I love
and
them.
You're not afraid to say
no,
yes.
No, I am not.
You'll say, I'll take two.
Yeah.
Anyway, we are so glad to have you with us because it is just, this is our 2013 celebration. The weather is a little on the brisk side, but as always, Pasadena weather still is the perfect backdrop. We have the Goodyear blimp overhead, and before you know it, we're going to see the stealth bomber. They're going to be coming at about 9:35 today, along with the tribute to the Korean War veterans.
Yeah, there's such an excitement, too, with the crowd sitting here. They've anticipated this moment for about an hour and a half since they've been coming into the bleachers, and we got here I don't know, right around 5 o'clock, I think.
Easily.
But Cindy,
well, yeah.
I'm so proud of you. You've been standing out there volunteering your time yeah. and services, getting people to go
well,
where they need to go
the
since,
thing
what,
is,
6 last night?
Since 6 last night. Yeah. It's this thing called the White Suitors, and it's the legend of Pasadena, and it all started back in the late 1800s, kind of as a, hey, take that, New York. We have better weather than you are. We can wear white after July.
Yeah.
And that's what that's all about.
The only caveat is that you had long underwear under your white suit, I would imagine.
I had many layers
that's
of
right.
long underwear, but let's not go there. Anyway, there's so many exciting things to tell you about. And in fact, I can't wait to see the Grand Marshal when she comes by. It's Dr. Jane Goodall, you know, and her love. She's 78 years young.
She's amazing,
isn't she? And
she
still spends 300 days out of the year traveling the world to save chimpanzees.
And she was inspired, apparently, by reading Tarzan.
Tarzan
right?
is a little girl. Yeah. And in fact, you know, people will ask her, well, what do you think? I mean, are chimpanzees really like people? And she'll say, yeah. And she'll say, well, do you prefer hanging out with a chimpanzee than a person? And she says, well, they're like people. There's some good chimps, there's some bad chimps, and
that's
maybe
funny.
There's chumps. Anyway, let's talk about some of these floats, because now as they're winding their way, now let's paint a picture. We're sitting right at the corner of Orange Grove and Colorado.
That's right.
With the mountains right the backdrop, and this is where the parade begins. And we're in the grandstands with a lot of the TV stations from all over the country.
And our first float is from Honda, obviously, which is so colorful and filled with just such an amazing array of flowers. Now we saw this under construction.
We talked to the designer,
that's
Dave
right.
Pittman, right? This was part of the Phoenix Design Group. And this is what he was explaining, that, you know, these designers, by the way, that on January 8th, they will begin their pitch as
for,
a marketing
for next
team
year.
For next year.
Right.
And it is a pitch. It's like, hey, brand X, here's why you should spend $300,000. It's going to be more valuable. You're going to be seen by more people all over the world, less than a 30-second spot in the Super Bowl.
Yeah, so it's a great bang for the buck, obviously, for these brands. And it's such a colorful and festive way to put your brand out there into the world. And
so this is the float by Honda. It's called Follow Your Dreams. And Honda, when asked by, you know, the designer that we talked to, Dave Pittman, they said, well, can you do better, longer?
It is.
Taller.
I think it's the longest, tallest float ever, isn't it?
And it's in three different sections, and so it's very complex. And it's basically telling the story of Follow Your Dreams.
That's right.
And
And don't forget, people, when these floats come from where they're constructed, they have to sort disassemble and collapse a bit. They fold down.
To make it under the freeways.
So they can get under freeway passes.
And, oh, no, what about that story, too? Because they get a police escort. Remember, we were talking with one of the professional float decorators, and they were saying, you know what, one time, they've seen everything.
Yeah,
one time, bank robbers were running down the street, and then all of a sudden they saw this police escort with these floats. I'm like, okay, I give up. And
yeah,
they just
the float foiled the bank robbery, apparently. Isn't that funny? Oh, this is a
oh,
great
boy, we love
up.
This. Are you ready for this? It's the U.S. Marine Corps, the Mounted Color Guard. Hey, come on, Julian, let's give it a good listen to our troops.
Representations of all the different periods in history with people wearing the costumes uniforms from all the different armed forces that have served our country. It's
and
beautiful.
Some women in there. Yeah.
Yep, you bet.
So there's quite the history of the Marine Corps participating in the Rose Parade. It just goes back, you know, since the 60s. And, of course, we have our Marine Corps station in Barstow and several parts of California, so there's quite the legacy there.
That's right. That's beautiful to see, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
And Camp Pendleton, of course, wearing the Marine Dress Blues. Gorgeous.
Now, this is a great-looking float coming up here. This is the City of Torrance Ace Clearwater Float, and there's a beautiful array of flowers with a kid in a hammock relaxing. And sort of a follow your dreams and be inspired.
With
and,
a spaceship of some kind,
and then behind
kind,
him,
yeah.
he's dreaming, and there's a rocket shooting up with a space shuttle. It's amazing, isn't it?
And I noticed, too, in watching some of the early designs, you're going to see a rainbow theme in several of the floats. And that, of course, signifying the whole idea of hope and the theme of, you know, oh, the places you'll go. Now, we should talk about speaking of the rainbow and the colors. Now, we know what goes into these colors, because Eric and I went to all these barns where they make these floats and they design them, and it starts with seeds. And what is the number one color for blue? You remember it? It's status.
Status, yes.
And it's grown quite heavily California. And by the way, there's two floats participating in this year's parade that are using only California-grown flowers. But status is the only flower, even though it's kind of purplish, that they can use for blue.
And blue is a tough color for them because they have to mix, you know, that status color with some lighter color tones to get different shades of blue. So
and when
really
you say
difficult.
Mix, they were using your fruity blender, your
you
smoothie
know it.
Blender.
They grind them up in a blender, all the seeds and flowers, and they create a mix, and it almost becomes the palette. Well, it does become the palette for painting using only these dry goods.
So the city of Torrance having a parade, or having a float in the parade, that's something that's it's been a tradition for that city for many, many years.
Hey, these are the Hawaii Pow Riders, right?
Oh, yeah.
That's great. They're honoring Leela. It's Grand Marshal Leela Cook they're honoring, right? Fantastic.
I guess so.
Leela Lawea Carrillo Cook. Yeah, that's the person they're honoring. It's beautiful. It's a bunch of beautiful people in Hawaiian garb on horseback.
When we come back, we're going to talk more about that, because that's our cue to take a quick break. We're listening to Eric Stromer, Cindy Dole. We are live at all the action here at the corner of Orange Grove and Colorado. Exclusive coverage of the Rose Parade here on KFWB News Talk 98.
And the queen, she likes some bread. If she saw white instead,
she'd raise a fuss,
and each of us would quickly lose his head.
Goodness!
Since this is a thought we dread.
It is America's New Year's celebration, a festival of floats, bands, and equestrians. We have all the excitement for you with exclusive KFWB coverage of the Pasadena Rose Parade. Here are your hosts, Cindy Dole and Eric Stromer.
Well, this is one of our favorite things to do. Thanks for sharing your New Year's Day with us. And thanks to our partners, the Lions Clubs International, for making this broadcast possible, because Eric and I are right here at the heart of all the action.
We
it never
sure
gets boring,
no,
does
it? No, it doesn't. And, you know, I wave, and I think they're all waving back at
they
me.
They are.
I think they might just be waving at me.
It brings out the kid in you.
Yeah,
and
it sure does.
I think when you see the faces of the people here in the crowds, in fact, that's what the designers tell us. That's what they live for, is the reaction. And sometimes the reaction is to those floats that are more simple.
Sure.
Or it might be the one with all the bells and the whistles and the effects. It just depends.
That's right. And by the way, here comes Jane Goodall, our Grand Marshal.
Oh my gosh.
Look at that. What a beautiful old antique carriage. She's sitting in it and surrounded by these amazing orange and yellow flowers with some moss hanging down. I mean, it just looks overwhelmingly
now,
beautiful.
Now, there also is a man just beside the carriage walking a dog on a leash. And I don't know whose dog that is. I'm going to look at my notes. But let me just tell you that Jane Goodall says that she knew from growing up with dogs that animals had emotion and empathy and intellect,
yep,
and that something was there. And then, as you mentioned, she read the book Tarzan, wanted to spend time in Africa, and then there was that link with chimpanzees, that they have those feelings.
Yeah, that's right. And now, go to her website at rootsandshoots.org. They have helped hundreds of thousands of people be acquainted with nature and understand how to preserve our planet and really kind of, you know, dedicate some of their time and energy to saving our world as it pertains to animals and nature. It's a beautiful organization.
Yeah, she says that she travels virtually almost every day
she
of the year.
She said 300 days a year, I think.
It's all about her wish is just to have all of us care more about the environment. And she's 78 years old. She's still in such great
shape.
She
looks amazing, huh?
She's so alert, and what a love for animals and, of course, for people. And I love that line about, hey, are chimpanzees and people really that different? She says, nah.
You know, I bet there's a lot out that are much better than some people.
Exactly.
I would imagine. Yeah.
Anyway, so now
look at it's La Cañada's float.
It's very
and
cute.
Dinosaur is what it is, and it's a self-built float, obviously. But actually, not obviously. It's pretty well done.
Well, it is beautifully done. This is the second float we've seen today with a little volcano and a smokestack coming out of it.
Oh, we missed the Dole float for the floats at home, and then it had fire coming out of a volcano. It was gorgeous.
You missed my little shaky, shaky, shaky dance.
Yeah,
we'll have to do that next time.
I don't know how you're not cold wearing that coconut bra. It's amazing.
But speaking of the self-builder floats, and we'll see several coconut bra. We're going to see several of them. And, you know, it's really something special, because there are many professional builders, four of them, at least three that are the big ones, Fiesta, Phoenix, and Artistic Entertainment. But then there's these little towns, just like La Cañada.
That's right.
And South Pasadena and Sierra Madre and Cal Poly and Burbank and Downey, who just basically raise the money on their own and build it from scratch.
And pulled it together, and it's a beautiful job, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Look at the size of this band. Oh, my goodness. Amazing. That's the Davis High Marching Band. Let's have a listen.
Yeah. Okay, traffic at one, on the ones. So these guys are from Kaysville, Utah, and we'd mentioned earlier, if you hadn't heard, I mean, what an honor when you consider that 200 groups all over the world audition for a chance to have one of these 22 spots. And then the bands themselves, once they luck out and get it, not just luck, but talent.
Right.
I mean, there's a couple hundred in the band, each of these bands, and they, boy, they're beaming with pride.
And this band did a city canvassing fundraising event where the townspeople actually helped pay for these guys to get here.
Isn't that amazing?
How the community rallies around this band to get the gift of music out to the Rose Parade.
And it is a good gift, isn't it? And it's expensive, as you know, with kids and in entertainment. I mean, you know, between the uniforms
and the
travel and the rehearsals and all that, you know?
Guess what, Dad? I need a trombone. I'm going to California. Can you imagine?
Hey, be careful what you wish
That's
for.
That's right. You bet. And here's some more fantastic folks on horseback. Isn't that beautiful?
Well, we're going to be seeing at least 300 horses and riders today, from the Andalusians to my favorites are the mini-me's. I love those little baby horses that look like they could fit in a dollhouse. But these are larger.
That's a primetime express mounted drill team, and they are something else. They're from 7 to 65, and, boy, you can tell these folks all know how to ride, don't they?
Yeah, they're from Texas, and they're having a good time in the parade, of course.
These guys do the competition drills, you know, so they can ride the barrels and all the competitive stuff as it pertains to horseback. Stuff.
And the ponytails are really long and curly, which is kind of fun to look at, you know.
It's amazing, isn't it? Seeing, you know, I drive up and down Orange Grove quite a bit in my day, but to just see a bunch of folks on horseback is so unusual, isn't it?
Well, and when you see the horses, you think, well, you can't forget that there's the pooper scoopers that are going to show up later on.
They're coming up right behind. Yeah, they're a pretty important part of this parade.
It's okay.
Yeah.
I know. I have to tell that to my old English sheepdogs.
Right.
It's all right. We love you. It doesn't matter.
Hey, here's the judge's special trophy that's going to the Shriners Hospital for Children. Now, this is helping children live their dreams.
These are two teddy bears, and it's kind of an animated float because their heads are kind of wobbling from side to side. And sitting on the float, of course, are a couple of Shriners and some young kids, of course. Kids that probably have been helped by the Shriners. And when you mentioned the award, we should explain what this is all about, because throughout the parade, we're going to be telling you about this one won that award and blah, blah, blah. And there are about 24 different float awards, and it's really competitive. And so the Tournament of Roses, they pick three judges every year, and they never can be the same. And these judges are trained on how to look at the float, and they examine the float twice, once during decoration, and then another time just hours before New Year's Day. And we talked to one of the judges, Brian Sullivan, and we'll talk more about what he said, but he is someone that we know from Descanso Gardens and knows all about gardening.
That's right.
He's got a critical eye. Anyway, you're listening to exclusive coverage of the 124th Rose Parade. Eric Stromer, Cindy Dole giving you a front row seat thanks to our friends, Lions Clubs International. Don't go away. We have more fun to share with you right here on KFWB News Talk 980. Welcome back. You're listening to special coverage of the Pasadena Rose Parade. Eric Stromer, Cindy Dole. We are bringing it to you because, well, it's just a special day.
I got to tell you, the Pride of the Dutchman band just came by, and they have hand-painted these clogs. They're all wearing clogs.
Oh, you're kidding.
And it took four people about, I don't know, something like 5 or 6 days to paint each and every one of these different clogs. I don't know how you march in clogs. I could barely dance in eighth grade.
Well, you were saying that you could do some great, like,
I used to be able to spin like crazy on my clogs
back in the day. Right on the tip, right?
That's right.
Just, see, you got a little secret.
I tell my kids that. They're like, Dad, that's really bad.
That's lame, Dad. Come on.
Clogs. What's the matter with you?
But again, another example of a very proud and talented band that made it all the way here and did something special. Now, the theme to this parade is Oh, the Places You Go, the Dr. Seuss theme. And so we have coming up next here the Kaiser Permanente float. And it has, of course, the Cat in the Hat. You got to have the Cat in the Hat.
And this is sort of an homage to the theme. This is Oh, the Healthy Things You Can Do. So it's kind of instructing kids to eat healthy, live a lifestyle that's going to keep your health up and always positive.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of kids swinging from these little trees. It all look like Dr. Seuss characters. And there's, of course, the Cat in the Hat, my favorite. Check him out. Wow, look at that. Now, that's, when you think about it, we saw these floats originally, and they were just sort of painted templates of a frame.
Mm-hmm.
And then slowly but surely over a couple of weeks' time, these seeds are glued on. And then right at the last minute, just a day or two ago,
the flowers
get put on.
So let's talk about the color, because when you look at that Cat in the Hat, that bright, bright red, it comes from red and white carnations. And we talked with just this past week with one of the designers, in fact, from Fiesta. And he was saying, carnations, we're going to see them in this year's float, have really come around. I don't know about you, but I grew up thinking of carnations as kind of like boring.
Yeah, that would be sort of the second choice
like,
flower.
Like, I don't want that from boyfriend. It's
dyed
green. But watch for it. You're going to see some, the carnation growers have kind of taken a cue from all of us. One's called Midnight, and it has a velvet purple, almost black tone to it. And so it's like, come on, it's okay now to buy that special someone carnations.
And from a design standpoint, you look at the carnation from where we are, and it really pops.
It does.
Because it's got such a large body in terms of being a flower, you really see it kind of shine off the float itself.
The designers love the carnations too, because unlike the roses and the orchids and some of the other flowers where the blooms open very quickly. Oh, there go the pooper scoopers. We're seeing some of the tournament of roses.
I gotta get one of those shovels for my backyard.
Gosh.
That's a beauty.
They have a quick, like maybe a minute to get in
there. The size of a wheelbarrow, that shovel. Look at that thing.
But anyway, the selection of the flowers.
Well, we should tell them the reason the pooper scooper's there, because the Wells Fargo stagecoach just came by, two of them. And obviously, paying homage to the Wells Fargo folks that used to deliver the mail and then get the bank opened up in California in the early part of the century. And it's beautiful. Look at all the flowers on top of that one, too. El Presidente's on his way. Look at that. Look at that beautiful car. That's got to be, what is that thing? That is something. That's the glamour car of the year. It was advertised by Packard as the glamour car of the year. That is something else. 1940, that's what it is. Boy, they've come a long way in terms of car design. I think that's kind of the old design, I think, is so much more beautiful than some of the cars we see today. Look at that.
When we say Presidente, we mean this is the president of the Tournament of Roses.
I just got back from Mexico, sorry.
And her name is Sally Bixby, and she kind of gave us a nice little warm welcome to kick off the parade, but now she's back in this beautiful, beautiful vehicle. It is the Packard Glamour Car, and it's a very rich kind of a burgundy color with those pink flowers all over and some white hydrangeas. Very puffy
and look,
beautiful contrast.
It says President's Family, and there's two cars behind with the entire extended family of the president.
But the idea is that, here is a woman. She's only the second woman to be the president of the Tournament of Roses organization, and the first as a nurse. And later on, very soon, we're going to be seeing why that was the impetus to have a float that celebrates nursing all over the country. And that was something that took 5 years of fundraising to get that.
Yeah, independently fundraising occurred with all the different nurses across the country. So many people participated to build this amazing float.
Yeah.
Great all marching band coming up. Look at these guys.
Of course, is not just any old band. This is the Pasadena City College Tournament of Roses Honor Band, which is basically a collection of the best high school bands from all over Southern California. When we come back, we're going to have more fun coming your way, because we are bringing to you the best parade in the world, the Tournament of Roses Parade. Eric Stromer, Cindy Dole, don't you go away on KFWB News Talk 980.
If I had 2 dozen roses and an old bottle of wine.
You're listening to exclusive coverage of the Pasadena Tournament of Roses Parade on KFWB News Talk 980. Here are your hosts, Cindy Dole and Eric Stromer.
And thanks to our partners, Lions Clubs International, we're having so much fun, and hopefully you are too, because this is a whole new year, and we have so many great things to look forward to,
And the excitement is coming because the Stanford float is passing in front of us, and people are going nuts in front of us
in
the stands.
Those girls look very chilly because they're wearing, little mini-me outfits. They have, basically bikinis on, but I guess it's not that cold to them. Although the women that went ahead just a moment ago were the gals that do the wave. We have to pay homage
queen,
to them.
The queen, obviously, yeah.
Well, yeah, it was the Tournament of Roses court, the queen and her court, and Vanessa Menjarez is such an amazing woman. She plans to study stem cell research to save lives. I mean, the people that win these beauty queen titles, they're not just beautiful women. They are intelligent, they are involved in the community, and it's a lot.
It really is. And when I was her age, it was exciting that I would actually go to school.
So from those girls to the cheerleaders who are looking gorgeous and cardinal, yep. Because after all, it is Stanford today at the Rose Bowl. And as I was driving around the Glendale area, I saw four Stanford buses, and it was the Stanford band. And here they are right now, those nuts who love to just kind of loose.
They kind of look like they tied one on last night. They're all sort of loose choreography.
It's their thing. It's like, we have a good time in school. Let's not take band music too seriously. Julian, let's give them a listen.
Comes the city of Glendale's Living the Good Life float, which is again just staggeringly beautiful, isn't it? And it's so cute. There's a trolley car in the front with passengers sitting in the trolley car, surrounded by beautiful vases of huge flowers, bouquets coming out on top.
Let's talk about some of those flowers.
Yeah.
Yes, there are roses, 10,000 of them in lavender and in white and gold and hot pink and red and orange. And by the way, some of the roses that you will see, and we hope you'll go to the post parade where these floats are parked for the next several days in Pasadena, some of the roses are from Ecuador, and you can't necessarily grow them in your yard. They are grown hydroponically with really kind of awkward-looking stems, so they wouldn't look pretty in your yard, than on a bush, but stunning colors. And then you asked about carnations. Yes, 250 of them in red and a number of other kinds of flowers. Gorgeous.
Hey, the Valley Hunt Club is now showing up in front of us, and boy, that is something else. It's a beautiful old carriage with four amazing
covered
horses.
Covered in roses and orchids, yeah.
Looks like our pooper scooper guys are following up behind again.
These are Frisian horses that are bred and raised by this one particular family in Visalia. And they're from the Netherlands, and they're so graceful, and they have a very, very dark black coat, and they're just very friendly horses.
And they look like sort of smaller versions of Clydesdales.
They do. That's a good point.
But they're black.
Because of their hooves.
Yeah.
But the Valley Hunt Club, by the way, which is... its heritage is the Tournament of Roses, and it was, the collaboration of the men in that organization, and the men with the Tournament of Roses, and eventually women who said, let's have a parade. Let's show the rest of the world that we have great flowers, we have great citrus. Maybe it'll make people come here. Well, guess what? It worked.
Yeah, stop.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Yeah, exactly. Stop already.
You can hear the U-Hauls coming again, darn it. No, we want you guys to come, but you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look at this next float. This is the Lutheran Hour Ministries. And, there really is only one float that's tied to any religious connotation at all. And it's because they have been in this parade forever. So they don't allow other the Tournament of Roses.
They've been sort of grandfathered in.
Exactly. Yeah. So it really isn't supposed to have a religious connotation, but because of their legacy, that's why. And they always have a beautiful, stunning float. And so they're partners.
This is beautiful coming up, the PAVA World Korean Traditional Marching Band. This is 200 people in this band coming up with traditional Korean garb, women marching in the front, followed by traditional folks wearing these golden robes that are blowing these amazing gold horns. And then behind them a standard band that's playing this beautiful song.
So when Eric and I spent the past couple weeks going to these places where these floats are put together, something that's so heartwarming for me is the volunteers who participate, because while there are the float designers and then there are the float makers and builders, and these are almost corporate, well, they are, they're corporations, but then there are also the cities that privately fundraise. At the end of the day, it comes down to volunteers who just want to get involved. And then when they sit in this grandstand, or maybe they camp outside somewhere along the route, or they watch on TV and they go, oh, wait a minute, that was my float, that one over there, I put those beans on there.
Yeah, that's right.
You know?
It's always a part of people's bucket list to come all over the world just to participate in decorating and understanding the spirit that is this Rose Parade.
And there is so much more to share, and you've got it right here. Eric Stromer, Cindy Dole, we're so proud to be here with you. Thanks for sharing your new day of the new year right with us on KFWB News Talk 980. Welcome back. You're listening to special coverage of the Pasadena Tournament of Roses Parade. I'm Cindy Dole.
Hey, I'm Eric Stromer. Hi, guys.
And, you know, remember, it was, gosh, not that long ago when everyone was saying, Honey Badger gets what it wants.
Yeah.
And, you know, that was kind of a phase because of that video that went viral. But the Badgers are always eternal for Wisconsin, back for their third time to compete in the Rose Bowl, and their band just going by right now. In fact, let's listen to the Badgers of Wisconsin. Go Badgers! Point out that this band was founded back in the 1800s.
I mean,
it's, you know, and it's huge. Look at the band. 300 plus musicians are in this Rose Parade.
I got to tell you something. I played drums, and these guys who are marching and playing those the snare drum.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. That's so difficult to do.
To stay
in
formation.
And they do it so effortlessly. Yeah, it's amazing.
And would you kind of like lose your rhythm? I mean,
they play to the tempo they walk most of the time, so it's a little bit easier that way.
Uh-huh.
But still, I mean, you know, these guys are amazing musicians.
Well, it's a big day for Wisconsin and for Stanford. Pick your favorite. Either way you look at it, it's
going
to be fun. Well, I don't know. I mean,
I might go Wisconsin because I spent my whole life going up there in the summer.
I think I might go for Wisconsin,
too. And I love cheese.
Too.
Who doesn't? Right?
I know. The cheeseheads. But anyway, the Wisconsin-Stanford teams are going to be going after from the Rose Parade. It's a big day for these guys and gals. Then they go over to the Rose Bowl, and it's going to be a big performance. Of course, they'll have a flyover, and then they have their
halftime.
Imagine
how much fun these guys are having being in college, playing in this game, and just being here in Pasadena for this day.
I know. I did it when I was at SC. It was a fly girl in the band.
We got to post you with pictures from that time on the website.
Okay, we will.
YourHomeWizards.com.
It is a lot of fun being in this parade because it's, what, 3 to 5 miles long, and it's, you know, it's tiring, but you're so...
So do you get, that's what I was going to ask, you get tired and exhilarated?
You get tired, but you're totally exhilarated. It isn't until the next day you crash. I mean, you're just going on energy because this is fun. This is like...
But then you have to go from here to the game,
right? Yeah, yeah.
And then, of course, the party at night.
And then they have to hurry up and get on a plane the next day.
Oh,
I mean, they don't get much time to stick around. But they are so excited. They're just living on that energy.
Hey, here's the beautiful city of Downey's. Do Drop By is the name of their float. It's self-built.
Uh-huh.
It's beautiful. It looks like a fallen tree in the forest.
And it's a fairy. We love fairies.
And some butterflies. And girls are... The fairies are wearing the little, like, sort of fairy tutus. It looks
very
fantastic.
Pretty. Yeah.
Looks like something my daughter would wear.
Now,
love it.
And when you talk about these fairy wings and the colors, I mean, these are vibrant oranges and yellows and blues. These float makers can't add paint, you know.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah. This is all natural.
I didn't know that until last year when I started to visit these floats with you, that it's all naturally occurring colors of nature. Nothing is enhanced artificially.
I mean, it can be dried flowers and straw flowers or beans or any of those things that they put in a blender and mix with other flowers, but
that's
can't be artificial. It can't
be painted. Now, that's the first time I've actually seen a float being towed by a tow truck, the Downey float.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that happens. Maybe they ran out of money halfway through.
That happens from time to time.
Yeah.
All right. Well, now this is the Salvation Army Tournament of Roses Band, and of course, I mean, every year, although throughout the year, we all think about the Salvation Army and how we can give back. And
that makes me think of Christmas when the guy stands out with the bell ringing in front of the department. So I love that.
But they were founded back in the 1800s in England, and it's just such a great cause. So let's listen to them for a moment. So coming up very quickly, right after this band, we're going to be seeing all kinds of cute animals. We're going to be seeing some cute horses, and then we're going to be seeing some dogs. Now, let's first talk about the horses, because we love these horses. These are the Saddlebreds, Scripps Miramar, and are they darling, the way that they're just kind of prancing?
Apparently they're praised because they've got this amazing temperament and eagerness and stamina. I mean, they're just amazing horses that have this sort of energy. It exudes energy that I no longer possess because I'm 50.
No. They do. They seem like they want to please. And what's the matter with that, right? They are the ultimate show horse. And it looks like they have a carriage like a USC Trojan behind them, you know?
They sure do, don't they?
And then right after that, this is a very sweet float that is put on by Beverly Hills Pet Care Foundation. And what it is all about adopting a pet.
Oh, that's really sweet. And they're all like bobblehead puppies on the float.
Yeah, that's a good way of putting it.
Yeah, they're really cute.
And so you're seeing all these different dogs for the most part. I see maybe a cat or two, but mostly dogs. And they're all covered with, again, natural materials, but they look so real. And when you look at the noses, I mean, a nice, cold nose on a dog, you know, is a sign of health and happiness. Well, these dog noses are probably made from things like, well, crushed black pepper.
Yep, that's right. Apparently there are 9 different shades to create this specific color that's on these animals. 9 different shades of gray to give you this color tone that you see right now.
Mm-hmm.
Which just looks like the soft fur of a puppy dog.
And they also have used a lot of the black and the white fluorographs depicting a Debbie Reynolds and other celebrity animal activists, crafted with onion seed and poppy seed and crushed sweet rice. And we'll get into more of some of those natural materials, but it is very interesting. And a lot of these designers, they never look at their pantry again the same way.
No, they don't.
Hey, I'm having this for dinner. Oh, that's going to be the float.
That's going to be the color of the eye on the fish.
And pampas grass, that's Eric Stromer's hair. There it is.
Hey, look at these gals that are standing on these horses right now.
They're
please.
From Canada. We got to go to the break.
Oh.
Coming up, you're listening to more of the fun right here at the corner of Orange Grove and Colorado. Eric Stromer, Cindy Dole. Thanks to our friends at Lions Clubs International. Exclusive parade coverage on KFWB.
Looks like money.